Hi guys, back for another video. So what I did on my channel today, we're gonna make a coffee mug in Fusion 360. So Fusion 360 is a modeling software made by Autodesk, a really good one. Like you can go from beginner to advanced, whichever you like, and make anything. Like literally make anything. So today I'm going to show you how to make a coffee mug. It's real simple. So let's start. So first, we're going to go to create sketch, because to make anything in Fusion 360, you need to have a sketch for it. So create sketch, and we go to this origin. So over here, we're gonna make the midpoint or the midline of the coffee mug first. Axis one. So we're gonna select line, and then anywhere on the green line, anywhere. So we select it, and then to the circle, we make the line. Then right 90 degrees to this, we're gonna make another one, okay? So this much, like proportion, you can just see it how much it is. So after that, I'm just gonna click okay, and then now we're gonna use fit point spline. What this is that we're gonna like we select two points and it like converts into a curve, so you'll see it. You must be thinking, what am I doing? Actually, I'm making the 2D or the main skeleton of the coffee mug. Like when you hold the coffee mug like on one side, when you view it from one of the sides, it looks like a 2D image. So like we are making the 2D image right now. So select one point over here, and then another, and then yep, okay. After we're done, we can just, you know, line, and then okay, now it's done. The sketch, this is the sketch. Now what the main part is that we are going to, you know, revolve it. Maybe you might know it, maybe you not, might not. So revolve is one of the features in this create drop down menu. This is like making stuff, and there's modify, assemble, construct, many things in the software. So we're gonna use revolve. Then what basically revolve is that it like takes one profile and then it moves it around making something, and around which the axis we're gonna select this, the midline. Okay, this is the axis. Now as you can see, it is made like a simple coffee mug is made, but I know it is not a really coffee mug because it is not hollow from inside. We're gonna make it. So after that, we're gonna press OK. Then we're gonna make it hollow. Now how to make it hollow, we are going to use one of the tools from here, okay? So we're gonna use shell. Once the shell is over here, we select this, and then this arrow comes over here. So what is this arrow for? This arrow is for the thickness, how much thickness you want the container to be. So this is your choice, how much ever you want, okay? Then, yep, nice. I think that's nice. Then I'm gonna click OK. And then to give it a more, you know, good look, we're gonna select this line, this inner line, as you can see. And then we're gonna right click it and press chamfer. So what chamfer does is that it just, you know, creates a surface on the line, then you can see it over here. Yeah? Okay. And I'm just, if you want it, you can do it. If not, it's fine, okay? For myself, I'm just doing like this. You can also do it like that. Then I'm gonna press OK. So this is the main container. Now we're gonna make the handle. To make the handle, we're gonna press create sketch again and then select one of these origins. I'm gonna use this one and then select a line or maybe fit point spline. I prefer fit point spline because it makes a curvy handle and not that line. It will be too blocky kind of feeling. Then I just start from here and then I'm gonna make our way to the end. Okay, that's good. Now that is done, we press finish sketch. Okay. So we have the main skeleton of the handle over here. Now to make the handle, let's move on to construct, okay? As we know that whenever we make a sketch, we need an origin, right? And to make like this mug, I needed these three origins. I'll show you. These three origins over there. So to make the handle, you need a different origin as well. So actually, the origin is not like there. We have to make another origin, and you can make an origin. So we click construct this drop down menu and then select the like the fifth or sixth. I don't know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, the seventh one. Okay, plane tangent to face set point. So what this is that we're gonna make our origin on this surface, but making origin on the surface is not, you know, it is not possible unless and until there is a point. So we have the face, like the surface and the point as well. So we click the face first, face and point, and then the point, and we have it over here. This is the origin to make a handle. So after it's done, you just click OK. And then to make the thickness, like how much thick you want the handle, you click this origin and then create sketch. Now we are over here, we're gonna use the 2-point triangle. So 2-point triangle is like we select 2 points and it makes a triangle. Okay, you must be, you know, confused. I'll show you. As you can see, I selected 1 point. Now the second point is done. Okay. Now this is the thickness, like how much thicker it's gonna be. So after that, I'm just gonna, you know, fill it. Fillet is like making curves instead of those corners. So like this, this, and this. So it's a really nice, you know, triangle with curves. Sorry, rectangle with curves, I'm sorry. Then we finish sketch and we have over here. Now the final step. Now we go to one of the tools in create. So we select sweep. So what sweep is that it selects a profile and a path. Okay, so this is the path through which it's gonna go, and this is the profile, how much thick it's gonna go. So we select profile and then click this. Okay, then the path, we click this. As you can see, it's pretty thick and we want it, but you can see it isn't red color. So what is red color? Actually, the red color means it's cutting it. So we don't want it to cut. So we're gonna make it join. So now this looks good. And now then we click OK. Here we have it. Maybe the handle is too big, but it is as you want. So it's nice. So guys, thanks for watching this video. I hope you liked it. I just, you know, tried a new software and just wanted to see how are your views. So if you like it, then subscribe, and if you want others to want it too, then you can share it and give it a thumbs up. Okay, I'll see you next time, maybe with this software. And maybe with more gaming. See ya.